Geez, I thought you guys were just going to talk about a movie, but this is pretty neat. I enlisted in 1964 and was sent to Vietnam right here in San Diego. In spring of 65, we left for Vietnam. Arrived about a month later. It took about a month. Arrived in the summertime in Vietnam. Now, this is my first trip out of the country. You know, it's 18 years old, barely got out of the state. You know, just to go camping and stuff when I was a kid. It was big to go to the other side of the world. I was in Vietnam in 65 and 66. I came back in 67, and then the first part of 68 is when the Tet Offensive started. And it started for us on January 21st. Somewhere in between that first week or so, one of the optic guys was supposed to take a gun sight to have it repaired for a cannon. And the guy we couldn't get him to move. So I volunteered. I just got on the plane, took the gun sight down to Da Nang. When I got to Da Nang, I had money and I went into the PX and there's a movie camera. I said, well, hey, my mom wants more movies of me and I'll get them. So I bought the Yashica Super 8 and whatever rolls of film they had for it, and went back up to Khe Sanh. You're seeing the pictures of it. Wasn't a hobby or anything. By looking at those movies, you could tell he was a total amateur. I couldn't get focused. What inspired me, I was in the middle of a battle. Didn't know it was a major battle or anything, but here's some action, let's get some. When you have something to do, you're not bored. There's a lot of bored guys there. I said, you want to come and help me work? We'll work on some trucks or something or whatever. They didn't want to leave the hole. Nobody wanted to leave. The first day, the ammo dump blew up. My next door neighbors took a direct hit in their bunker. Didn't kill everyone, but it messed them up really bad. So that was probably one of the worst days that I had anywhere. They'd fire on us continuously during the day to keep us awake, the artillery, and at night we just all kept thinking they're going to come and attack us. So after like 2 and 3 in the morning is when they started doing these attacking. They probed into different places of the base. Never knew when it was going to end. It just never seemed to end. We really could never get on the other side of the wire to go fight them. During the Tet Offensive, there was a lot of problems. It's just that Khe Sanh lasted so long. You know, and when's this gonna get over? I mean, fear rides it constantly on you. And I don't remember sleeping, but I know I had to. It's insane. It's insane. Would I do it again? I would. This time I figure that I'd die this time though. I go, well, the pain that I've been suffering the last 40 years has been unbelievable. It's an emotional pain that just tears you right up. Can't function right. So, you know, I've had my share of bad knocks. All the memories are actually pretty good. It's just trauma in a lot of them, you know, but that's what you joined the Marine Corps for, was to get into all that. You know, it's like a test. You know, you go in, war. I didn't expect it to come, but it did. And you just have to handle yourself in it. I'm here. Yeah.